dumped in by the Kings. But there's a penalty here against the Sharks. Interference is the call. That'll send the Kings to a power play. And now McDermott drops the gloves with Veal.
Veal's not a heavyweight, but he's game. And it's part of his game to be involved. You can see McDermott getting a little bit of an edge with the rights over the top, but also controlling with a grab hand. And off balance, and the linesman say, okay, that's enough. So McDermott threw about 8 or 9, and Veal was probably not able to get any off on the play. The Kings, it appeared, were going to have a power play here. And if everything goes normal after that, meaning 5 minutes each for fighting, then the Kings would have the man advantage opportunity. It looks like the officials getting together to try to discuss how both guys came together. Again, if you're trying to start something, if you leave your normal position, you can talk about it. Those types of things going on. So up the ice, it looked like the interference took place with Veal making contact. McDermott does come across, and he follows him across. He pushes and shoves.
56 LA's got 5 for fighting and 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. 63 San Jose's got 2 for interference and a 5 minutes for fighting. 5 on 5, Grace.
So they do even it up. Unsportsmanlike conduct is the call. There once was a time when men, tough men, played this game. But now there's a time where a push on the back is unsportsmanlike conduct.
I understand an instigating, but he didn't even do that.
Well, you know, instigating is...
Because he didn't come that far across. No, he was already engaged with him.
Yes. That's the second game in a row, unfortunately, for Curtis McDermott, where he picks up a penalty due to his reputation.